Greetings, everyone. I hope that you're all having a wonderful and blessed Wednesday. So are you still missing your $1,400 third stimulus check? Or maybe you have not even received your first or second stimulus payment. So in today's video, I'll be sharing what you need to do if you want to receive your missing stimulus money. I will also be going over the latest fourth stimulus checks and infrastructure package news. Thank you so much, everyone, for being here today. This coming Friday evening, I will be giving away more $75 Amazon gift cards. To enter the giveaway, all you need to do is subscribe to my channel, share and like this video, and also comment below. Thank you so much, everyone. So Democratic Senator Joe Manchin recently told reporters that he opposes using the maneuver that would enable the Democratic Party to pass President Joe Biden's $2.3 trillion infrastructure proposal without any Republican support, noting that he favors a smaller and more targeted bill. This is not very surprising. Before the $1.9 trillion American Rescue Plan was passed, Senator Joe Manchin said that he would rather support more targeted relief. Currently, Senator Manchin, a West Virginia moderate, holds in power to block the Democratic lawmakers' agenda in the evenly divided Senate. Joe Manchin has already rejected the idea of using the budgetary reconciliation process, a process to pass President Biden's proposed $2.3 trillion infrastructure legislation. While most legislation needs 60 votes to advance in the 100-seat Senate, the budget reconciliation process allows for a simple majority. Thankfully, Democrats also control the Senate because Vice President Kamala Harris can cast a tie-breaking vote. More targeted, Manchin told CNN's State of the Union program, referring to a bill that would incorporate internet broadband, roads, and water infrastructure needs. When asked if he would back another bill with other related spending through a process called reconciliation, Senator Manchin said no. Joe Biden's sweeping proposals in his infrastructure proposal include $400 billion for in-home and community-based care for the elderly and disabled. In addition, there is $100 billion for school and childcare facilities. Those are two areas that Republican lawmakers left out of their $568 billion counteroffer. Joe Manchin said while such areas need to be addressed, it was hard to build public support for a massive bill that goes beyond what he called traditional infrastructure needs. Manchin also told CNN, "I think they should be separated. When you start pulling so much into one bill, it makes it very, very difficult for the public to understand." He called the Republican proposal a good start for negotiations. So what do you think, everyone? How much should the federal government spend on Biden's infrastructure package? Please leave your thoughts in the comment section below. Republican Senator Lindsey Graham told Fox that he met with Manchin last week to discuss the infrastructure bill, adding that while he opposes the cost of Biden's plan, he was optimistic Republicans and Democrats could work out a deal. Republicans do oppose Biden's ambitious legislative agenda right now. However, things could change in the near future.
We're not only talking about staying open, we're talking about growing so that childcare is better after COVID than it was before. Because COVID exposed so many of the problems, the structural problems in a modern 21st century society, which we hadn't caught up with. And one of them is childcare. So the needs for childcare have greatly increased, but our society didn't catch up with it. Of the 37 OECD nations, that's the most developed countries in the world, when it comes to childcare, the US is number 36. It's a place where we lagged, but COVID made it clear. And today I can report that this critical child care help is on the way. We've close to doubled the child tax credit. Starting in July, if you're a single parent who makes under $75,000, if you're a couple who makes under $150,000, the federal government will send you $300 for every child 0 to 6 per month and $250 for every child 6 to 17. First, that's going to take half the kids in America and half the kids in Central New York out of poverty. That's amazing. And that money can be used. We made it not just for the poorest of families, but for middle class families as well. Guess what a lot of families can use that money for? To help pay for childcare.
I know that many of you are asking, where is my stimulus payment? I have not yet received my stimulus check yet. It is really unfortunate that many of you are still missing your stimulus money, but luckily there is a way to claim the missing funds. Submitting a tax return this tax season can help you if you're still owed the recent $1,400 stimulus payment. It can also help resolve the situation if you are missing either both or one of the first two stimulus checks up to $1,200 or the $600. The federal tax filing deadline has been extended to May 17th this year. According to a spokesman for the IRS, if you miss that date, you can still claim any missing stimulus check by filing for the funds on October 15th tax filing extension deadline. However, there are advantages to submitting earlier. For one, the sooner you put in for any missing stimulus money, the sooner you may receive it. It is important to remember that even though you are due a stimulus check, you could owe taxes that are more than that sum. It is important to remember that even though you are due a stimulus check, you could owe taxes that are more than that sum. If you decide to take a tax filing extension, you only have one more time to submit your return, not to pay any money you owe. Interest and penalties could accrue on any balance you owe the IRS. Some of you could be eligible for a top-off payment if the tax return you submit this tax season shows that your income dropped since last year, or you have added another dependent to your family. Most of you that receive federal benefits should have received your payment automatically. However, the IRS has urged federal beneficiaries to file a return in order to make sure their eligible dependents are included. The government is also encouraging people who it does not have on record to file tax returns in order to get their stimulus checks, most especially the homeless or the rural poor. If you think that the Internal Revenue Service owes you a full or partial stimulus check for any reason, you can claim missing stimulus money by filing a recovery rebate credit as part of your 2020 taxes. You need to file for the credit when you submit your federal tax return this year. File for your missing money from the first and or second stimulus on the 2020 Form 1040 or the Form 1040 SR. That is the end of the video, everyone. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comment section below. And please do not forget to enter the $75 Amazon gift card giveaway, which is scheduled for this coming Friday evening. All you need to do is subscribe to my channel, share and like this video, and also leave a comment below. Thank you, everyone, and have a very, very blessed Wednesday.